Emperor is awaiting your arrival at the palace.
I know he is, Major. What are his wishes?
Our next acquisition, Your Majesty.
I realize that this meeting connotates to war effort in your mind, Siege. But I haven't called you here with that in mind. I trust you to see things through many perspectives in a situation as crucial as this. War can be won through many means.
Such as diplomacy.
So you've heard. No doubt you see the obvious in a diversion like this, even though I haven't shared any information with you yet. I assume that you know of the planet of Corin?
Naturally, sire. It is a planet ruled by a well-liked monarch. Corin has always praised peace and democracy, but strength is quite clearly not in their open vocabulary.
I've heard rumors that the Republic will be negotiating with them for a treaty of annexation.
And you were thinking of beating them to it. I take it that the ore is what spawned this newfound interest for this particular planet.
That ore is regenerative, unique in its kind. The Republic believe that obtaining the ore is what will tip the scales in their favor. And innocent as they are, they will no doubt send Jedi representatives to charm the king and queen to sign a treaty with them.
Jedi?
Of course. I don't have the benefit of sending such charming people into their embrace. But I certainly do have the capacity of sending a warrior with a white flag. I would like you to go and press the issue for us. I'm growing tired of King Duster's stalling.
When do I leave?
Immediately. We don't want anything stopping us from achieving this goal.
Very well, Your Majesty. I will take my leave. Sorry.
I know I lectured you quite a bit there, Raven. But despite your errors, you actually performed quite well. You have proven that you can handle yourself in a dogfight.
Thank you, Master Solon.
If you continue doing this well, it won't be much longer until you're ready for the trials.
Thank you. Your future lies with me.
Raven, are you okay? You look a bit dazed.
I'm fine, Seth.
Good, because Soren wants to see you in the council chamber.
Okay, thanks.
The Council has called you here to present you with an assignment. Recently, the Republic has approached the planet of Corin with an offer of annexation. Unfortunately, the Skenvi Empire has also approached Corin with an offer of their own. Now, they are more likely concerned with the planet's resources, its unique ore, than they are with the people.
The only reason that we are approaching Corin now is because of their ore.
Remember the stakes here. If the Skenvi were to gain exclusive rights to Corin's ore, the Republic would be that much closer to losing this war.
Don't remind me. I've been in the front lines. We are barely holding it on our own as it is.
May the Force be with you.
Another mission, Master. This is overkill.
I must admit, I did feel something in the Force when we returned. Hence my suggestion that you should get some rest.
But I was looking forward to continuing my studies.
You will still be able to. A firm grasp of diplomacy can often be a Jedi's greatest asset. Having the strength and skill to win a fight, it's not nearly as important as being able to avoid one in the first place. Now, go pack your things and we'll leave as soon as you're ready.
Two boys must be the Jedi I am transporting. The name's Kairos Khan. I will be your pilot for this mission.
I'm Soren Dar. This is my apprentice, Raven Darkham.
Nice to meet you both. If you follow me, we can be on our way.
Today, Ariana.
You say that every day, Mother.
It's because you look beautiful every day. Is something wrong, dear?
I am to be Queen of Corin. I am to marry a handsome young man from one of the noble houses. It isn't that I don't like this life. I do. I mean, everything about my future is already decided for me.
You want to be something beyond what you were given. I know the feeling. I never wanted to marry your father. I had it set in my mind that I would fall in love with a man and then marry him, regardless of what my parents wanted.
So your parents forced you to marry?
No. They gave me all the time I needed to make my decision, and your father courted me for nearly a year. And in the end, I realized I hadn't even given Jester a chance. Sometimes, Ariana, we grow to love the roles we are forced to. Something else bothers you?
Yes. Do you know the feeling you get when someone is watching you?
Yes, why?
The ambassador from the Skenvi Empire is here to see you, my lady.
Maybe you should handle this matter, my dear. As a queen, you'll have to deal with such people whether you like them or not. And it might even irk his lordship when he finds out that I didn't even take the time to see him. It will be all right.
I will see him in the main hall.
Of course.
Welcome, Ambassador. I am Princess Ariana. You asked for an audience.
With the King and Queen, child. Are they otherwise occupied? Or do my rank and status earn me nothing more than calculated insolence?
My parents will be meeting Jedi Knights from the New Republic today to discuss Corin joining the Republic. And if that happens...
The vaunted freedoms of the New Republic. I see that sovereignty, however, isn't one of them. The Empire, on the other hand, encourages all profitable trade relationships, so long as our systems put Skenvi interests first.
The Republic has our best interests at heart, while, as far as I can tell, the Skenvi are only interested in our minerals.
You malign us, my lady. We fear for the health of your economy. The Republic is small, and simply cannot provide you with the market you require. The Empire can. But if you join the Republic and you are forced to embargo us, the consequences for your people would be disastrous. But of course, I have faith that your family will make the wiser choice. After all, the King and Queen do have the best interests of the people at heart.
Skills with the saber is progressing quite well.
We're coming up on Corain. We'll be leaving hyperspace in a few seconds.
Master, now that I'm done my studies, I wish to discuss something with you. I had a dream earlier. It was clear, vivid. Not like my other dreams.
A vision?
Maybe. I don't know.
The Jedi must always be mindful of his dreams, Raven. Especially when they're out of the ordinary. Consider what you saw. Meditate on it. We will discuss this when we settle in on Corin.
Traffic control. This is the light fighter Starstream requesting permission to land. I'm carrying the Republic ambassadors.
This is Corin Air Traffic Control. Thank you, Starstream. You're granted.
Mm-hmm.
Ambassador, I'm Captain Turbo, the Royal Guard. My men and I will escort you to the palace.
I hear the King and Queen are well loved by the people.
They are indeed. I'm afraid you won't be meeting with them right away, however.
No?
No. They will be available for an audience later today, but they have requested that you first meet with their daughter, the Princess Ariana.
Well, of course. A future queen would no doubt need to practice her skills of diplomacy.
Follow me, young Jedi. The princess is in the throne room.
You must be the Jedi I'm meeting with. I'm Princess Ariana.
My name is Raven Darkham.
You're so nervous.
I must admit, I've never met a princess before.
I too have a confession. I never met a Jedi Knight before.
Actually, m'lady, you still haven't. I'm not quite a Jedi Knight yet. I'm only a student.
If you're a student, then where's your master?
He's around someplace. He trusted me to handle this matter alone.
You may come sit next to me, Raven Darkham. Don't worry, my parents will not mind us using their seats. So, what exactly does a Jedi do?
We're peacekeepers and ambassadors mostly.
They seem to get along well.
Yes, I must say, I'm gratified that the Republic deems us important enough to send two Jedi as ambassadors.
Every system is important to the Republic.
But some more than most, no? What would the Republic say if we were in to join the Scanvi instead and deny you access to our roar?
If you want to join the Scanvi Empire, it's your right to do so. If I would like to take a stroll out of the window, it's also my right.
Mm-hmm. A fine assessment of the situation.
You are in the Flit as well?
Well, what can I say? We Jedi are versatile.
Not to mention insufferably self-centered. And here I was trying to discuss important affairs with you.
Very well then. Why does Corrin wish to join with the Republic?
There are rumors of an invasion if we do not cooperate. The Republic would be able to defend us, as we do not have the forces nor the resources to defend ourselves. Plus, it's good to have a Jedi on our side.
I guess that concludes our business. I will relay your answers to the Senate.
Thank you. And now, with the business out of the way, would you like to see the Royal Gardens? I am retiring there now. Would love for a Jedi to accompany me.
Lead the way, m'lady.
And here's where I like to practice my fencing. What's so funny?
I'm sorry, but I just can't imagine a princess fencing.
Who would you like to see? Would you like to have a friendly duel?
I accept.
Young love. Touching, isn't it? Do you know, Your Grace, what Jedi philosophy says about attachments?
Perhaps you could enlighten us, Lord Siege.
It says that a Jedi must forsake all attachments, that he may better serve the Force. That is why candidates for their academy are taken at such a young age, and why they are forbidden to love.
And yet, the Jedi Master throws his apprentice headlong into your romantic trap, knowing full well what the outcome will be. Perhaps, Your Grace, it would do you well to remember this as a lesson.
A lesson about what?
The quickest judgment about a man may often prove to be the furthest from the truth.
I think my judgment about you and the Skenvi Empire is quite sound.
It's a bit different than a lightsaber, but it'll do.
Are you ready?
As ready as I ever been, Princess.
Remember, don't hold back. I see you're learning.
If you think spouting platitudes...
But if I were you, I would look carefully at my new allies.
Which is why the Corinne will never join the Skenvi.
No less than I expected. When the end comes, Your Grace, you may reconsider your words, although it will be far too late.
Are you threatening us?
When Skenvi warships occupy your orbitals, and your cities are awash in flame, you find yourself a king over nothing but ashes and memories. Perhaps you will look back and wish that you had chosen a position of strength over one of weakness. Corrin is merely an objective in this war, a resource to be fought over. Strip away the self-righteous web of lies, and you will find that the Republic feels much the same way. And what of you when you become a burden to your new allies, your new friends? Corrin is weak. And in this galaxy, Your Grace, weakness invites betrayal.
You're really good.
That was quite a show. You're very talented, Princess.
I'm sure Soran and his student are exhausted from their trip here and could use some bit of a rest. Ariana, would you be so kind to show them to the guest rooms?
Certainly, Father. If you follow me, gentlemen.
princess. Your parents told me that you are very perceptive towards others' feelings. Do you often have strong emotion towards others only by their presence? Or perhaps know that they're nearby before that you can hear and see them?
All the time. Mother says it's a gift that I have been blessed with. Here's your room, gentlemen. Take as long as you need to rest. My parents will meet with you afterwards to finalize the negotiations.
Your hospitality is much appreciated.
Rest well.
I will.
The force is strong in her.
I know. I felt it when we were fencing. But it's too late for her to begin the training.
The Council have made exceptions in the past. I speak to Master Johan Korn when we return.
You've fallen for the boy, haven't you? I'm happy for you. But there is one thing you must know. The Jedi. Members of the Order are not allowed to get involved. Romantically. At all. Maybe it's better if you don't attend the finalizing of the negotiations. Your father and I can handle it on our own. My dear, forget about him.
Falaish! Could you please go and remind my wife about the meeting? She was last headed toward the Prince's quarters.
Certainly, Grace.
Raven, how about you accompany her? You won't be missing much here.
Certainly, Master.
Stay here.
Go get my master.
stop! Why? We don't have time for this! There!
Princess. I know your tricks, Sith. You and your outdated Jedi Order know nothing!
Ariana has always been strong. So if anyone could survive this, it's her.
We'll do what we can to return her safely.
But Your Grace, please do not let this interfere with the negotiations.
You have received the demands of the Skenvi Empire. But please, do not listen.
We will get your daughter back.
I swear we will return her and kill the man that did this.
The man you are seeking is named Lord Siege. He is an ambassador of the Skenvi Empire. I wish both of you the best of luck. And please, bring my daughter back safely. She's all I have now.
Come on.
Ah! What's more, we confronted him on Corin and found out that his school in Ways of the Force. A lone dark Jedi, if we are lucky.
But you don't believe so?
No. He disguised himself too well, fought too masterfully. He's a Sith.
This is dire news indeed. I will discuss this with the Council. But you must
do everything that you can to find out more about this man. Pursue him and
rescue the princess, if she's not sold or dead already. But above all else, be careful. You might be in more danger than you realize. What else is troubling you?
It's Raven. He has become emotionally attached.
Watch him then, closely. His involvement with her can be dealt with later. For now, you must make sure that this quest of yours does not become an instrument of vengeance for him.
I agree.
Contact me when you know more.
I will.
Chancellor Doran, what can I do for you?
The Corin Queen has been murdered and her daughter kidnapped by the Skenvi Ambassador Lord Siege. I hold your order responsible for this disaster.
But Chancellor Doran...
And I have ordered the Naval Task Force to search for the princess and bring her back to her father. Your Jedi are to remain at Corin and leave this to the Republic.
Kevin Gagger again. Her screaming is enough to give you a Mompratz headache.
Not yet. I'd like to have a few words with the princess first. I see that breaking you will take more than just physical pain. The Force can do terrible things to both mind and flesh. Twist you in ways you never thought now, I will leave you with the threat of such agony. Tell me, Princess, if I were to disable the binds and free you, what would you do?
I would kill you.
Such violence. Such hate. What if I told you you can do that without even lifting a finger? Kill me while still bound to that chair. You are strong in the Force. Very strong. With sufficient training, even I would be hard-pressed to match you.
Is that what you want? To turn me into a Sith?
In time, yes. But I think you will find your alternatives rather limited in that regard. Not even your precious Jedi friends can save you now.
Liar! Raven will come for me!
Of course he will. And when he does, we shall truly test the bounds of your resistance.
What are you talking about?
How do you think it will feel to watch as I break him? To stand witness as I peel away one by one all the layers of his sanity? And leave him a gibbering shell of what he once was.
No, you don't touch him!
What if I were to turn him instead of you? You've already suffered my betrayal and the consequent death of your mother. But can you suffer his? Can you endure treachery? One you
You may gag her now, Shatilk. When the time comes, I shall have all of my enemies sitting in the palm of my hand.
Why do you still hold me, Tasha? The man you knew.
The ship you're tracking. The Navi computer is 90% positive. This is where they are headed, judging by their trajectory.
A space station? In what system?
Seems our boy is taking the princess to Imperda. It's a space station that operates within the black market. More specifically with the slave dealing.
We have to get there right away.
Thank you, Carrot. Stay on course.
Sure thing.
You shouldn't worry. It clouds and distracts the mind.
I've tried burying these feelings, but they're overpowering me.
Then I think you should sit this mission out.
I will not stand by and watch.
I'm sorry, Master. I did not mean to shout.
Raven, I fear for you. Your feeling towards this girl has clouded your judgment. Your only concern should be about what helps bring Corrin into the Republic. But you are turning this into a personal quest for revenge. You fear for the girl. And you're angry at our inability to immediately rescue her. You hate Lord Seas for what he's doing to her. To you! Hate him with a passion that threatens to consume.
I've heard this all before. Is wanting justice for what he's done going to lead to the dark side?
This is not justice that you want! It's vengeance, and there's a difference! You are an exceptional student, Raven. And you have come a long way since I took you as my padawan. But it still seems that you haven't understood any of it!
Gentlemen, we'll be coming out of hyperspace shortly.
We will continue this discussion later.
Welcome to Imperda, Master Jedi. You won't find a more wretched hive of scum and villainy. This side of hot space, at least. Imperda Station, this is the Light Freighter Starstream requesting permission to dock.
Enjoy your stay.
I meant what I said earlier, Raven. If you get identified, you will endanger Adriana's life. The thing is, I will also decline. Our faces are much too familiar, you see. You, on the other hand, are a complete stranger on Imperta. And you will blend in with a depraved scum just as a regular resident. If, and I say if, I try to market the princess as a slave, this will roughly satisfy the coffers of the usual slave trader.
I will return with the princess. I promise.
Try not to draw too much attention to yourself, Icarus. Be careful.
What's your pleasure, sir?
I'll have a tipsy drink and a slave sail advisor whenever one's available.
A slave sail advisor? I think you got the wrong place, sir.
That's really too bad. I just love the smell of a distraught young lady encased in chains. Don't you?
Sir, there's a sale and you're invited.
I don't want anything.
Ah, don't disappoint old Jim Buchel now. He's got good stuff, good stuff. Take this. Still good FK9? FK89? Works without a body. Now, what do you think?
I don't want a protocol droid.
Everyone needs one.
We'll get you off my back.
Yep, 9 Republic credits.
Advisor receives you now.
Something specific. I got business interests that pay me good credits as long as they sate certain urges. Female, definitely. Attractive.
Oh, you are nuts both, my friend.
bid a simple smuggler like you get a currency like this, if you don't mind me asking?
Let's just say that I done some people a few favors, and I do mind.
I don't have a lot of girls that's worth this kind of credits.
Yes, you have to trust me.
Follow me.
Not the right age I'm looking for. Meet me back at the diner later.
We've been looking for you,
Lucas Khan.
I don't owe your boss anything.
Not you, human, but you know who does.
Yeah, you can find her yourself.
Concern for your sister. That's sad. She had a contract. Debts to pay.
Debts that aren't mine.
You may not value family, human, but she does.
Okay, we don't need to be violent about it. I'll come quietly. As I said, not my debt.
It is now.
Soren, things aren't going so smoothly out here. I'm sure she's up on this slave auction platform.
It's horrible, I know. We can only hope.
Thank you.
With the greatest respect. This makes no sense, my lord. You put the current princess up in a slave auction. What if she'd slipped out of our hands?
Kneel!
The auction itself was fixed. I use her to get the Jedi to come to me. Get in front of here. Next time I won't be so lenient.
Precisely is that?
An unbroken slave girl?
Don't look elsewhere then. All I have is
special.
Rather someone else.
By special, you mean expensive?
Never touch me again.
Why is she special?
Because it's force sensitive.
But price is no object, I have. Customers who would sell their own children for something like that. Is she attractive? Young but not a child?
All of that and more. So you're interested?
Practically drooling.
Meet me at Port 12 in half an hour, and I'll have the girl waiting.
Princess, I'm meeting with Scanlon in half an hour for pickup and payment.
Be careful. Lord Sage will be nearby, and if he discovers your true thoughts and intentions, then it's all over.
I'll do my best.
Sober the Hutt invites outsiders to view his private collection of bounties frozen in carbonite to D20
in permatime. This is the girl?
Yes. Oh, that's Electro Bynes. She's not exactly the smartest. Kept trying to escape.
Ha! How much?
50,000.
I didn't pay half that much on my first ship. 15.
The girl's a force user. You can find a heap of scrap, like most of the ships docked virtually anywhere. 40.
An untrained force user, 25.
If she was trained, we both would be dead by now. Give me 30,000 credits and that's my final offer.
I can deal with that. I'll take her. Good doing business with you.
I bought the princess. I'm monitoring the position with the tracking device I planted on her.
Good. Alert me when he reaches his docking bay.
Princess Ariana. My name is Kairos Khan. I'm accompanied by the Jedis, and I'm here to rescue you.
Sir, they're in dock report 6-1.
Perfect. Lock down all ships in a docking bay immediately.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Now we got them.
I see them. Stop right there. Open fire! Squad 5, follow me. Squad 4 to Hangar Bay 61. Yes, sir. Stop, you're under... Oh.
Hurry up, princess!
What are your orders, sir? Stop them before they take off! Open fire! Objects are fleeing from Sector 14.
Roto defense system activated. Charge 80%. 90%. Cannons ready. On.
My dear, forget about it.
Are you okay?
It stings a little.
You just have to learn to detach yourself from it. When you can ignore the pain, it all seems to go away.
I can't imagine a Jedi like you acting as childish as me over such a small thing.
Jedi have years of training to ignore pain. But just between you and me, even a simple cut can drive the strongest of Jedi insane at times.
Your parents must be so proud of you.
Actually, they don't know much about me. I was taken from my home planet when I was 3 years old to become a Jedi Knight. I haven't seen my parents since. I plan on going back to my home planet after I become a full Jedi Knight.
I can't imagine being away from my parents for that long. That monster. He murdered my mother. He tortured me. He said he would...
It's all right. He's gone. You'll never have to see him again.
Never again. No. He's coming.
What was that?
Our friends are back, and they're not too happy about us tricking them.
Faster! We should be gaining on them! Why haven't we jumped to light speed yet?
I need to work on the coordinates a little bit more.
Can you lose him?
Maybe. There's an asteroid field up ahead. We can take cover there.
Ah!
throw away the lives of the princess and your smuggler friend just for a chance to save yourself.
You'll never have the princess, Sith.
If you want her,
you'll have to get past me first.
Buckle yourselves in. This may get bumpy.
Leave this to me!
Okay, let's go to light speed.
Not quite yet.
Thank you.
I had a feeling that you were piloting Raven. That was... What's wrong?
Siege. He's dead.
It's all over and I never even saw him.
Revenge is never as satisfying as we believe it will be, Raven. You think it ends a conflict, settles a score. But in fact, it only internalizes it. Take my advice and forget about it. If you don't, you go on hating him in the dark corners of your mind, simply because he denied you of your satisfaction.
Yes, Master. I will try not to dwell on it.
Where's Corin?
I don't know. The ship just came out of hyperspace on its own. It seems we exited prematurely. We're still a day away from the planet. That asteroid impact must have damaged the hyperdrive.
Is there anything you can do to fix it?
Until we reach Corain, I don't have the spare parts to fix this.
We simply have to wait.
Corrine Air Traffic Control, this is the Light Rider Star Stream. We have urgent business with the King and we're requiring docking space immediately. Corrine Air Traffic Control.
That's on?
They aren't responding. I'll stay on the ship and wait. I doubt that I would feel too comfortable in a palace surrounded by royalty. But if you could ask the King about a new hyperdrive, though, I would really appreciate it.
I'll ask. Seem to want us dead. You won't win this time.
Siege. Oh, but I already have. In a single blow, I've taken this planet right from the Republic's grasp. When the King signs our treaty of annexation, the Republic will be powerless to act. And the Empire will have the advantage it needs to win this war. Which brings me to a point I've been meaning to make for quite some time. Now that I have the King, I no longer need the princess.
No!
I knew it. He just used the stun blaster. You'll be okay. To go back, may I suggest we sneak in through the back of the palace?
Assuming the royal guards are still alive. Land behind the palace.
Yes, my lady.
Thank you.
Crappy armor. Take this.
Come on, it's just around the corner.
Oh, identify yourself.
This may be a problem.
It's the princess. Get her.
Get down.
Seal the prisoners in the holding cells.
Ah!
So it ends, boy. Or perhaps so it begins.
My lord!
What is best for her?
That's why we're making the request.
The council has discussed the matter. It would be an honor if our Princess Ariana were to return to Yavin with us to begin her training as a Jedi. I sense your feelings. We cannot and will not force you to do this. But we do believe that it would be in both hers and the Republic's best interest.
My wife always had a feeling that Ariana was meant for greater things than the crown. But I always passed it off as nonsense.
You don't have to make a decision just yet.
If the council believes that it is her destiny to become a great Jedi, who am I to deny it? It's her future. And if Ariana is up to the challenge, she has my full approval. When it comes time for me to step down, Ariana must return to take my place.
Agreed.
By the power vested in me, and on behalf of the Senate, I hereby welcome the planet of Corin to the New Republic. I hope it is everything you imagined it to be.
It's already far grander than I could have wished, thanks to the Republic. My daughter is safe, and the people of Corin need not to fear another era of tyranny.
This concludes the ceremony. We wish the people of Corin a glorious future, but remind them that the present time is one of darkness. We must all stand fast against the rising tide of evil.
What will happen if my father agrees to the council's request?
He will be trained as a Jedi at the Yavin Temple.
With you?
With me. I promise. I won't let anything happen to you again. Ever.
What's wrong? I thought you wanted this.
I'm a Jedi. And soon you will be one also. Ariana, I want you more than anything in the galaxy. But you're the one thing I can't ever have.
What if I lose you again? Do you know what I would do to get you back? But we don't know what destiny has in store for us. Only time will tell.